Welcome back. Time to take a look at stories doing the rounds across the country and internationally, starting with the national capital, New Delhi. More than 2 lakh voters have increased this time compared to the previous Lok Sabha elections in Delhi. According to the Chief Election Commissioner, 1.5 lakh youth will vote for the first time in the upcoming Lok Sabha polls. Aam Aadmi Party government faces flak for putting up posters on government buses. May have violated the election code of conduct. No end to politics over Lok Sabha poll dates. Aam Aadmi Party has raised objection over the poll dates. Aam Aadmi Party claims that BJP will be benefiting if polls are held during the holy month of Ramzan. Aam Aadmi Party held a meeting at the residence of Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal to decide on the strategy for the Lok Sabha elections. Aam Aadmi Party is planning to burn the 2014 manifesto of Bharatiya Janata Party on March 13 for failing to honour the full statehood promise. Delhi Congress held a meeting to strengthen booths ahead of Lok Sabha elections. Congress chief Rahul Gandhi slammed BJP and claimed that Congress will be winning all the 7 seats. However, he did not mention anything about Congress and Aam Aadmi Party relationship. After a Delhi court wrapped the Aam Aadmi Party government for not granting the requisite sanction to prosecute former JNU Students Union President Kanhaiya Kumar and others in a 2016 sedition case, Aam Aadmi Party has now sought 2 weeks' time from the court. However, the High Court will continue with the hearings. Heavy rains lashed the national capital and the adjoining areas after witnessing a slight dry weather. Traffic snarls at many places in Gurugram also were witnessed because of the heavy rains. Major fire broke out in a cardboard factory in Uttar Pradesh's Greater Noida. Over a dozen fire tenders were rushed to the spot to douse the fire. No casualties have been reported. Noida police has launched patrolling to curb the snatching and loot issues in the area. 60 electronic bikes were introduced for patrolling. Let's now take a look at all the stories from the financial capital, Mumbai. NCP Supremo Sharad Pawar has once again made a U-turn on his decision to contest the Lok Sabha elections. Pawar announced that he will not contest the upcoming Lok Sabha polls from the Madhav constituency, as was announced earlier. He said that the decision has been changed because his grandnephew Parth Pawar and his daughter Supriya will be contesting the elections. He added that he doesn't want more than 2 people from Pawar family to be in the poll contest. Meanwhile, the BJP has accused Sharad Pawar of being scared of fighting the polls. Former MPA daughter of actor Sunil Dutt will be contesting the Lok Sabha polls from Mumbai North Central constituency. This after her earlier reluctance to join the poll battle. Sources suggest that she was convinced by party president Rahul Gandhi to join the poll fray. Her reluctance was attributed to internal feud in the Congress. However, Priya Dutt's name is now likely to figure in the first list of Congress candidates in Mumbai. In what could be termed as bad news for Congress stalwart Sushil Kumar Shinde, who is contesting from the Solapur constituency, Babasaheb Ambedkar's grandson and BRP Bahujan Party leader Prakash Ambedkar have decided to contest from Solapur. In fact, the Congress fears that its traditional vote base will be divided and would give advantage to the Shiv Sena BJP combine. In a jolt to MNS chief Raj Thackeray, one of his MLAs have joined the Shiv Sena after quitting the party. Over the past few days, Thackeray has been lashing out at the BJP and Prime Minister Narendra Modi over the Pulwama suicide attack. The MNS has been attempting to forge a pre-poll alliance with the NCP but has achieved no success so far. The Shiv Sena has taken a dig at its ally BJP over alleged politicization of the airstrikes carried out by the Indian Air Force. An editorial in Sena's mouthpiece Samna hit out at BJP MP Manoj Tiwari, who had donned military fatigue at a bike rally. The Sena said it is regrettable that the poll panel had to issue directions over highlighting of military achievement for political gains. The Samna editorial says nationalism can't be a monopoly of one party. The BJP workers from Ahmednagar district are dismayed over speculations that a senior Congress leader's son would join the Saffron Party. They expressed their ire in front of Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis. The BJP workers fear that Radhakrishna Patil's son, Shujoy, will be joining the party and it would be jeopardizing chances of sitting MP Dilip Gandhi. The BJP workers also question Shujoy's loyalty. Ahead of the crucial Lok Sabha polls, several sitting BJP MPs are likely to not get tickets again. Sources suggest that BJP State Parliamentary Committee will be taking the decision about candidates after going through various surveys conducted by the party. The BJP had 123 seats in 2014 and this time it will be contesting from 25 seats in the state. The Bombay High Court has directed the BMC and other state authorities in Maharashtra to ensure the implementation of the model code of conduct for Lok Sabha polls and that doesn't bring the administration to a halt. The court was hearing a petition seeking directions to the BMC to appoint experts to its tree authority. The tree authority holds the power to grant permissions for felling of trees for developmental projects. The Enforcement Directorate has filed a supplementary charge sheet against Nirav Modi's wife, Amy Modi, in the PNB fraud case. She has been named as an accused in the case in a special Mumbai court. Amy has been charged for her alleged involvement in laundering proceeds from funds obtained fraudulently from the PNB. According to ED, the funds were used to purchase a flat at Central Park in New York for $30 million. Stories now from Bangalore. Union Minister Anand Kumar Hegde has once again stoked a row. He has questioned Rahul Gandhi, asking him to show proof whether he is a Brahmin or not. While addressing a gathering at Karnataka's Karwar, Anand Kumar Hegde, referring to Rahul Gandhi, questioned how a son born to a Muslim father and a Christian mother became a Brahmin. He said that Rahul Gandhi must provide his DNA test and later ask for proof of the recent airstrikes on Pakistan's Balakot. Not willing to give up on Chief Minister's post, BJP State President B.S. Yedurappa has said that if the party gets 22 seats in the Lok Sabha polls in Karnataka, then his party will come back to power in the state. He said, and I quote, "It is not too far for the BJP to rule the state, and I am not saying with arrogance, but I'm saying this. If the BJP wins 22 seats in the Lok Sabha elections, then within 24 hours, I will form the government in the state," unquote. With coalition partners, Congress and JDS still struggling to come to a seat-sharing deal for Lok Sabha polls and local leaders making no secret of their animosity, cracks seem to deepen in the coalition. The JDS is demanding a minimum 9 to 10 parliamentary seats of the total of 28, including high-profile ones like Mandya, Mysuru, Hassan, Tumkuru and Chikkabalapur, where the Congress workers want party candidates to contest from. A few Congress legislators and ex-MLAs of these five districts have openly told state leaders that they will be remaining neutral if their seats are given to the JDS. Three youth died while taking selfies near a waterfall in Uttara Kannada district. According to sources, they slipped and fell in the fast-flowing waters. The locals managed to fish their bodies out of the river, but it was too late. A shocking case of apathy comes across from Karnataka's Hubballi district. In a video that has now gone viral, one can see a patient falling from his bed and rolling on the floor, but the doctors are not bothered. In fact, a doctor was present when the incident took place. However, he chose to look the other way because they were busy on their mobile phones. The video is from Hubballi's KIMS hospital. Let's look at stories now from the state of Tamil Nadu. Kamal Haasan's party Makkal Neethi Maayam interviewed aspirants for the Lok Sabha polls at Chennai party office on Monday. A total of 1,137 aspirants submitted the application forms. The interviews were overlooked by party chief Kamal Haasan. Kamal Haasan had earlier announced on Twitter that the party's symbol would be a battery torch. Political parties and citizen groups have raised concerns about the election dates in Tamil Nadu clashing with the religious Chidarai festival in the state, in which lakhs of people participate from across the country. Tamil Nadu Chief Election Officer has sought a report from the Madurai collector on the same and will be sending it to the Election Commission for consideration. DMK Chief MK Stalin has questioned the decision to have bi-polls only in 18 vacant constituencies and has asked for bi-polls in all the 21 vacant constituencies in the state. DMK leaders Tirushi Siva and TKS Elangovan will be handing over a memorandum to the EC on Tuesday, and if all the options are exhausted, the DMK will go to court over this issue. Coimbatore police have arrested 8 men for allegedly molesting and sexually harassing a woman student. The woman was harassed over a period of 7 years. She was targeted through social media. AIADMK youth wing member from Polashi, who is also one of the accused in the case, has been expelled from the party. He was arrested by the police for attacking the survivor's brother. The official announcement is out for actor Arya's next venture, Teddy. The poster of the film indicates that it will be a children's movie. Produced by K.E. Raja, Shakti Sondar will be directing the film, and D. Imam has been roped in for the film's music. Let's now take a look at stories from Telangana. Hit by defection, the Congress's Telangana unit has decided to boycott the Legislative Council election. The party has issued a whip in this regard. 5 of its MLAs have joined the TRS in the past 1 month, and the Congress has accused the ruling party in the state of poaching its MLAs. AIMIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi slammed politicians and clerics for creating unnecessary controversy over the poll dates falling during the month of Ramzan. Owaisi said, and I quote, "As a Muslim, I welcome the elections in Ramzan. In this Ramzan, the Muslim vote percentage will be increased," unquote. TRS chief and Telangana chief minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao is all set to kickstart the party's poll campaign from his daughter K. Kavita's parliamentary constituency. KCR will be addressing a mega rally in Nizamabad on March 19th. In a big boost to the opposition, YSR Congress Party, top cine actor Ali joined the party in presence of its chief Vice Jagan Mohan Reddy in Hyderabad. Ali is likely to contest from Guntur. Meanwhile, Chandrasekhar, who is the brother of top TDP leader and minister Devineni Uma Maheshwar Rao, has also joined the YSR Congress Party. To intensify its watch on the rising pollution levels, Telangana State Pollution Control Board is planning to increase the network of continuous ambient air quality monitoring stations in the city. A total of 7 new monitoring stations will be set up at different strategic locations in the city. The plan comes in the wake of Central Pollution Control Board issuing guidelines to the state-run pollution control boards to set up more stations in the cities, exceeding a population of over 50 lakh. And it's time now for stories that are doing the rounds in Kolkata. A brawl erupted between the Congress and the TMC workers in West Bengal's North Dinajpur area over a shooting incident. The row erupted after 2 alleged Congress workers were shot. One of the injured persons accused the TMC supporters of shooting him. However, the TMC accused the Congress and the CPM of creating trouble in the region. TMC Minister Firhad Hakim has lashed out at the centre over the dates announced for the Lok Sabha polls. He alleged that the Modi government has incorrectly briefed the Election Commission about Bengal. Meanwhile, he's also said that all those leaders who are quitting the party to join the BJP are opportunists. Congress MP Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary has once again vouched for an alliance with the CPIM. He said that Murshidabad seat must be left to the Congress, as the party has won twice from there. He said that CPIM has lost its support base in Murshidabad in the past 5 years and they must give in to the Congress. Upping the ante against the BJP, the Shiv Sena has demanded a CBI probe in the Rafal fighter jet deal. The party's West Bengal president met CBI officials in Kolkata to put forth the demand. The Shiv Sena has decided to attack the BJP politically in West Bengal. TMC leader Anubrata Mondal said that party chief Mamata Banerjee will declare the names of candidates soon for the Lok Sabha polls. She appealed to the voters to cast their votes for the TMC. The party has already begun the poll campaign for the Lok Sabha elections. And let's now take a look at stories doing the rounds internationally. At least 7 people have died in the floods caused by torrential rains in and around Brazil's largest city, Sao Paulo. Some of the victims are believed to be from the same family after their homes collapsed on the outskirts of Sao Paulo metropolitan area. Traffic in Brazil's economic hub was thrown into chaos, with aerial images showing large swaths of the city underwater. A memorial was held on Monday for the crew of Ethiopian Airlines plane that crashed on Sunday, killing all the 157 people on board. People went looking and they wept looking at photographs of the crew members placed on the chairs on a stage. Ethiopian Airlines 737 MAX 8 plunged into a farmland minutes after takeoff from Addis Ababa from Nairobi on Sunday. The victims came from more than 30 nations and included 22 United Nations staff. U.S. Special Representative for North Korea, Stephen Biegun, said on Monday that diplomacy is still very much alive with North Korea despite the collapse of a summit between U.S. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un last month. An unwell Serena Williams retired from the BNP Paribas Open while trailing Spain's Garbiñ Muguruza 6-3-1-0 at Indian Wells on March 10th. Tournament officials said that the former world number one was suffering from a viral illness. Windsurfers took to the sea at Magirote Beach in Ireland on Sunday to take part in the latest Red Bull Storm Chase. 8 of the world's best and most adventurous windsurfers traveled to the county Donegal in northwest corner of Ireland to take part in the event, which challenges them to compete and perform tricks in extremely stormy conditions. Stories now from the world of films and entertainment. Actors Amitabh Bachchan and Tapsee Pannu's latest outing, Badla, has earned 23.2 crores in the opening weekend. Interestingly, Badla has also beaten the opening weekend collections of Amitabh Bachchan's Pink, which had earned 21.51 crores, and 102 Not Out, which minted 16.65 crores at the domestic box office. There's good news for Zoya Akhtar as she is planning to make a sequel to her latest directorial Gully Boy. The Ranveer Singh Alia Bhatt starrer is based on the rap scenes of Mumbai and has minted 131.3 crores at the domestic market. Actor Shahid Kapoor has signed a new film where he will reportedly be seen as a biker. The actor, who has already started preparing for the film, was recently in news after he proudly boasted owning the rare model of BMW R1250 GS Adventure on his Instagram page. Actor Ishan Khattar, whose performance in Dhadak was widely appreciated, has been offered a biopic on freedom fighter Birsa Munda. According to reports, Ishan heard the narration and liked it and has verbally given his nod to the film. Actor Nawazuddin Siddiqui, who was last seen in Thackeray, will be soon seen in his brother Shamas Siddiqui's directorial Bole Chuniya. Moni Roy has been roped in as the female lead for the film, and the film is expected to go on floors in May this year. News and updates continue right here on India Today. Stay tuned for more.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.